In this lesson, we'll learn how to create a master document. And this is useful if you have a series of existing documents that you want to bring into one main or master document. Examples might be product manuals, task procedure lists, maybe chapter books, things that you have already in separate files that you want to bring into one main file. And so in order to show you how to do this, we are going to go into the outline view. So I've got a blank document on my screen. I'm going to click view and choose outline. And now I'm in my outlining view. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click show document. And this is within the master document section here. And the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to insert documents. So let's say I'm writing a book and I've already got a couple of chapters written. And each chapter is in a separate Word document. So I'm going to click Insert here. I'm going to go and find my document. And it's called Chapter 1. And when I do that, it places it into the outline view. And you see Chapter 1, which has already been typed in, and all of the text that's associated with that file will show up within this area here. Now I can keep going and I can insert more chapters into my main document. And I'm going to insert chapter 2, which is going to be placed after chapter 1. And you see my cursor is down here underneath chapter 2, so I'm going to insert now chapter 3. And if you scroll, you'll see that we now have chapter 1, chapter 2, and chapter 3 placed within this document. At this point, I can close my outline view. And this takes us back to the page layout view. What I'm going to do is I'm going to scroll up to the top. And you'll notice that we have a blank page as page 1. If you look at your Show Hide button, you'll see that there's been a section break inserted in page 1. So you can remove that if you like, or you can make this your cover page. Scroll down, and we have chapter 1 is placed on the first page. There's a section break placed after chapter 1. And then we've got chapter 2 on the next page, along with another section break, and then chapter 3. I'm going to turn off my Show Hide button, scroll back up to the top, and let's go ahead and give this document a name. I'm going to go to File and Save As, and I'm going to call this Master Document. Click Save, and I'm going to close it. Now when I want to open that file back up, I'm going to find it within my computer's directory, Master Document. Now, the interesting thing is when you open up a master document, once your documents have been placed within it, the first time you open it back up, you're going to have links to your chapters. Now, you could actually link back and press your control button and click to go to that particular file within your computer's system. However, if we want to view all of these documents, what we need to do is we need to go back into the View tab, go back into the Outline view, and we're going to choose Expand Subdocuments, and then close our Outline view. This takes us to a point where we can either print or view our master document. Now, another thing you can do with this is, let's say, for example, that you have information that changes in any one of your chapters. I'm going to go ahead and close this again. And this time I'm going to open up my Chapter 1 individual file. And let's say that I make a change here, and we're just going to make a simple change. I'm going to highlight video, I'm going to make it bold, and italicize it. And I'm going to click Save. I'm now going to close my chapter file. and reopen my master document. Again, I have these links here that show up on my screen. In order to remove the links and view the text, I'm going to go to my View tab, back to Outline, Expand Subdocuments. And when I close my outline view and go to the page which has Chapter 1, you'll see that my Word video here has been changed. And so that is an indicator that there's actually a link in between the chapters. So what you can do is you can make changes to those chapters even after you've created your master document and they are linked to your master document so that you can make sure that they update as you go. And that's how you would create a master document within Word.